Hey guys, it's Nate, aka The Foot Accountant. Welcome back to the channel. I want to talk about the next upcoming promo that is most likely to be happening in FIFA 21. That is this Friday, and that is Winter Refresh. I want to talk through what you can expect, what you need to know, and what information do we have already? What information are we still waiting on? Because Winter Refresh has always been kind of like a hodgepodge promo, if you will, from EA. They kind of just throw things together and call it a Winter Refresh. And that's kind of the promo. Icon moments, icon swaps, the Winter Refresh player or Winter Ones to Watches in years of past. Winter upgrades, skill move, and rating upgrades are all a part of that as well. And also transferred players, they kind of formalize their addition to those players in the game. So we'll talk about that. Also talk about kind of rewards today, future stars, marquee matchups, what you can kind of expect, because there's some moves I think we can make on the market today as well, kind of take a second peek at. But first, let's talk about this promo, right? Winter Refresh. Last year, it came literally the same weekend, like 2 weeks after what they had run as Future Stars last year. It came on like February 14th. And actually, the reason why I'm putting this video out today is last year on Thursday, this is how EA released Winter Refresh. Kind of out of nowhere, they dropped this loading screen right here with this on the screen as you entered FIFA. And they just kind of said tomorrow, right? Hashtag Winter Refresh. And they actually gave us the players that were going to be upgraded and the actual new transfers, the player additions, if you will, and also the weak foot or skill move upgrades. So we got some Foot Economist spreadsheets last year with the upgrades that they released. So obviously this last year, we haven't had any information really leading up till today. The only information that we've had about Winter Refresh and stuff that usually comes with Winter Refresh is these icon moments dynamic images that were added into the code, the game code in FIFA. So these are the icon moments images on Imgur. They were uploaded, all, what is it, like 99 or 100 of those icons that are going to have a icon moments card. We should see these very soon. This is like our only hint that Winter Refresh is coming as of right now. The things that we're still waiting on include stuff added to the pack code for icon swaps or, you know, those types of things, like maybe a new couple of packs for icon swaps. Once we get the confirmation of those, then we would really think that Winter Refresh is coming. Now, I guess technically they wouldn't have to run icon swaps as a part of this promo, but it would almost make sense that they would run icon swaps along with it. It just makes sense, right? We've been without icon swaps now for a couple days. It seems like they should be starting number two or set two of those swaps, but nothing has been added yet into the game. So what else is Winter Refresh about? Well, last year we had this team that was added to packs, and this basically was a new version of Winter Ones to Watch. There weren't that many big time transfers last year. There was a few, right? You had Bruno, of course, Zlatan, Eriksen, Ake, Schulz, Herrera, Van Aanholt. All of these cards transferred to new clubs during the winter transfer window last year in FIFA, and EA gave them boosted up cards instead of giving them Ones to Watch live items and said, here, wait for them to get informs. They just said, here, here's an upgraded item. They were not live. I know a lot of people were wondering, do these cards get upgraded? No, it was a one-time permanent upgrade. And you know, it honestly, last year when they released this, it was kind of like EA picked out these specific cards and said, hey, there's not a lot of Bundesliga left backs in FIFA. Let's give Schulz a card. Or there's not a lot of right wings from the Serie A or for the League One. Let's give Cornet and Chiesa a card. And especially giving Areola a card, there weren't as many goalkeepers that were French. And of course, you had the big names, Zlatan, Eriksen, and Bruno in there. So honestly, last year, this Winter Refresh promo, and it was funny reading some of the comments underneath these tweets, this tweet by EA Sports, people were not very happy. And number one thing that was a big L about Winter Refresh last year were these player upgrades. They only upgraded the top 50 people that are the highest upgrades in FIFA. They were only doing plus three overalls and higher. So like we had this Wilfried Ndidi who got a plus three, Vardy got a plus three, Daniel James plus three. We talked about this in an early video specifically about winter upgrades, but I really hope that they don't do this plus three nonsense again and do plus ones and plus twos and like they used to do in FIFA 19 and earlier, because that was actually pretty hype. So that's one thing that really we wouldn't see any like hints for. But again, the reason why I am putting this video out for you guys today is literally last year on this day, the Thursday right before Winter Refresh did come, on the Thursday, at 6 p.m. UK, 1 p.m., right? My time. They dropped this loading screen. They tweeted this out and they said, hey, tomorrow is winter refresh. They told us what cards they were going to upgrade. And then, of course, with them putting these Icon Moments cards on the design, we were like, all right, we're getting Icon Moments. And we didn't know what this was as a winter refresh card. But maybe we don't have the actual winter refresh cards this year. Maybe there's some stuff that's going to be added to the pack code. But as I'm recording this video right now, the only thing that we really know could be coming this Friday is these Icon Moments. And the winter refresh has just always been a part of Icon Moments, or vice versa. Icon Moments a part of winter refresh. That's why we're assuming winter refresh is coming this Friday. So they did a League SBC challenge update last year with this as well. And I mean, this would be very hype if they did do that, but I don't think the League SBCs expire for a while. But I think 20 days or so. So that, you know, I do think that is something that we really need, is we need players in these League SBCs. Please, EA Sports. The fact that they've only been packs this year is a big L, honestly. And the packs are, you know, not as good anyway. So we do need some of those players in there. But other things that you can kind of expect for this weekend guaranteed on the market-wise, if it's revolving around winter refresh, especially the Icon Moment, since that is something that we're kind of quote-unquote looking for right now and we kind of expect, definitely keep an eye on some of the panic selling on these Icon cards, because even though you probably won't see a lot of these prime Icon Moments when they come on the market, they're going to be very expensive. And a lot of these regular icons, the base, the mid, the prime versions, are going to get panic sold. You will see a lot of those bounce back because people will just not be able to afford the Moments versions straight off the bat of a lot of these items. They're going to be expensive. And especially if they only release one batch, if they do one batch this weekend and one batch next weekend, then you're probably going to see some players from batch one that, you know, you panic sold, saw panic sold, and they weren't even in batch one. You're waiting for them in batch two, and that could mean your panic selling would rebound right back because people going buy that icon back that didn't get a Moments card. So that's kind of one thing to watch out for. I think you can get involved with the panic on Friday morning if you want to, and specifically if they give us more information today. Hopefully today on Thursday we get more info about winter refresh and about Icon Moments, because that's really what we need, right? And again, I keep mentioning this, but so far we really don't even have like any card designs added to the code. Usually that kind of stuff would come maybe tonight, maybe on a Thursday night, kind of late. We'll see. They did update some code with the Party Bag SBC earlier in the day, kind of like in the morning time. So that was very interesting. They did that kind of later. But when it comes to refresh as a whole and the promo, and we'll round up the winter refresh talk by talking about this, again, it's just kind of all these things that are kind of just smushed together. And it's like, okay, you know, we got some winter upgrades, yes, which people aren't investing for this year because we haven't had any, you know, clues really on that. There's been a little bit of investing, but not as much. Players like Sun, players like Bruno Fernandes, they really aren't rising up as they usually or in years past would be. Because of the way EA did upgrades last year, there's just not as much hype and not as many people are thinking about it. But those cards could be getting upgraded. So if you want to do some looking around, SoFIFA.com, I'll put the link in the description, is a great place to do some research and looking for which types of special cards might get upgraded just based off of their plus one, plus two, or plus three, and then kind of going by that criteria and seeing which cards special items could be getting boosted. So I'll put that link down below if you want to do a little bit of research there. But we're really just looking for more information from EA, but we do expect that winter refresh promo is coming, right? And again, it was kind of an L of a promo from last year. And if there, honestly, I guess there is just the absolute slightest of chance that there is no promo this weekend. And that would make things very interesting. And I think a lot of people would be very confused. But I guess, honestly, from EA's standpoint, and we'll find out more today, I'm just kind of releasing my thoughts right now, I guess. If EA did not release a promo this weekend, the only thing that I could see why they did that would be because we had all of these objectives released and we still have all of these SBCs that are out right now. And they, I guess, could say in their minds, hey, people on FIFA are busy enough right now. We don't need to drop a promo this weekend or whatever. So I'm not sure if that's going to happen or what they're going to do this weekend as of right now. Hopefully we do get some more information, because that would be very nice and very necessary, I think. There's a nice undercut here on Ruben Diaz. But let's kind of transition out of talking about the Winter Refresh promo. And if you guys have any questions on that, comment down below, of course, if you have any of those. It is kind of a simple promo in the sense that there's not anything like massive going on, but it's also confusing in the sense about just a lot of different parts to it. So a lot of different parts, but they're not really big parts. A lot of small things kind of added in. So if you have any questions, of course, drop them down below. But let's talk about rewards today and about this Fofana objective, because this card right here, I'm honestly thinking that this is going to be one of the most completed objectives over the next, in this FIFA, honestly. I think this objective is going to be completed like nuts, right? French links, Premier League. A lot of people are wishing they would have given this card just a little bit more of a boost. 80 pace, of course, would have been nice. 80 passing would have looked good on the card as well. 3,500 upvotes on Footbin. I think a lot of people are doing this objective card because, again, the links. And this is the card that everybody wanted from the get-go. When we had a center back that was going to be French as an SBC, we knew was coming. Everybody wanted it to be Fofana. And, of course, we now are getting this card. We have three Future Stars objectives now. I don't think we'll get any more unless they're going to release these after Future Stars is over, which wouldn't make sense. So it's honestly looking like to me, we got a striker, we got a midfielder, we got our defender, and those are our three Foot Future Stars Academy players, Renier, Cucurella, and Fofana. So if you're grinding these GLs, first of all, but I think Renier and Fofana are going to be the most completed out of these three, and I think Fofana is going to be the number one completed out of all of these anyways, and you're probably going to see a lot of people start to work on this if you haven't done it already after this weekend league, because again, there's a lot of demand for this weekend league with the weekend league plus objective, and for the second time in a row, when they put out weekend league plus objectives, we have gotten basically an L of a team of the week, right? Aubameyang, Lukaku, Llorente, and Didi are kind of like the major guys that you want to pack from this week's team of the week. Last time we had this out, it was an L as well. No Messi in team of the week today. No Ferland Mendy, as some people projected. And that was an L, right? So I'm honestly, with the weekend that I have coming up, I'm not even possibly looking at playing foot champs. And it's going to be sweaty out there, but honestly, not for good reason, because you're probably just going to be filling your club with extra red picks. I guess if you got the time and you usually play weekend league, go for it. You know, maybe go to 17 wins instead of 14 and get that extra player pick. And maybe you can do a foot champs upgrade with that player pick or whatever. But it doesn't really look super worth the grind to me, honestly. Now, I want to talk about a couple things that could also happen today on Thursday. We had the El Shaarawy. SBC fodder is dropping big time. It's dropping a lot, actually, because of UCL marquee matchups that we had yesterday on Wednesday, right? We are going to be getting regular marquee matchups released today on Thursday, which will be more supply for this market. And of course, with rewards coming in a few hours as well, SBC fodder, in my opinion, is going to be a major, major look for today. Whether you're buying it during rewards for a bounce afterwards, then you might see a dip a little bit again. Specifically during rewards, I think this stuff's going to look really, really good. You can see that SBCs have dropped a lot in price. Take a look at El Shaarawy. He's 230,000 coins to complete. He was 290 yesterday when he came out. This guy's down 60,000 coins. That's how cheap fodder is right now. A lot of this stuff has dropped off. It's going to drop a little bit more into rewards, and then I think it bounces back because the second party bag SBC could be coming out today, and I think people are going to invest for one, expecting that SBC to come out today, since the first one's going to be expiring. And the last time when they released those double 85s during the first week of Future Stars, and during Team of the Year, I think they released 85 plus as well, or no, that was not Team of the Year, that was during Future Stars set one. They released them on Monday and I think on Thursday. So they did the double. And also during Headliners, they did a double as well, party bag. So I think we're expecting another party bag today. That would be the most logical thing that we would expect to see. Most likely not a player SBC, but maybe EA would drop one more. All I'm saying is watch fodder during rewards. It should drop and then rebound nicely after that. And that could be a nice pickup, either if you want to do the SBC for cheaper or if you want to make some coins. Look at the fodder that goes nuts every single time. Like we were looking on stream today about like Sule, Acerbi, some of these center backs, right? Center backs go absolutely crazy on fodder this year. for the SBCs that require links. This Sule was down to 14,000 coins today. Looks like he's almost back there again. Yeah, he's back to 14,000 coins. This guy was 25K earlier this week because of the Party Bag SBC. 25K. He's down 10,000 coins a card. Get on the bids during rewards if you're awake. This is mad money. Even if you're buying like an hour or two after rewards, it's literally just going to keep going up. It's going to keep going up because people are going to invest in it, number one. And two, people are going to be finishing off SBCs or see that fodder is low and start to do SBCs after they get cards and coins from weekend league rewards. So big time fodder movements, I think, on the market today, and also with future stars players, right? We saw how much they dropped today with some supply. Some of them have kind of rebounded back a little bit, but cards like this Newhouse, man, this guy was 200,000 coins earlier, I think on Monday, and right now he is 150K. This is a Hullet Gang center midfielder, German links in the Bundesliga. Pretty solid links, really good looking card, and he's 150K. That's crazy. I do think some of these future stars are going to get low during rewards and then bounce back. The meta ones, for sure, Reece James, Bastoni, Tapsoba, Ruben Diaz, Reyna, Anthony as well. I think these cards are going to continue to bouncing around. They're going to rise after rewards for sure. Kind of like how we expect the team of the week to fluctuate, being packed and then rising later. I think you'll see that with these future stars today as well. You will see them bounce back nicely. Now, you also might see them dip a little bit after 6 p.m. content with marquee matchups coming out. So, you know, some of the cards that are more rare, like an Antony or like a Gio Reyna, who's very high rated, you might see them get their lowest during rewards, rebound a little bit, and then drop a little bit again as we head into the marquee matchups kind of time period. But you also might see some cards get low, rebound, and then get down to the same exact point they were because of that marquee matchup supply, especially some of the lower rated ones that get packed a lot, like Linus, Dalot, Oscar, and Estupinan. You might see those guys get packed a little bit more during marquee matchups and their prices stay kind of low. And then same thing with the team of the week, right? I know last week everybody watched Sterling go from 415K to 520K after rewards. If there's a card that's going to do that this week, it is either Aubameyang or Llorente, right? Those are like the two most premier cards in the team of the week this week. So keep an eye on those two. Those two are what I feel like the only chance at making a big time rebound after rewards, because those are the only two like desirable players in my mind that are in this team of the week. So definitely watch out for those kind of market movements today. The Party Bag SBC would be one other thing, I guess, that we would be expecting. But with Weekend League rewards, the Weekend League a plus objectives adding extra demand, I do have plenty of Thursday flips. I'm basically broke, right? I have 18,000 coins. I got all my coins and flips, about 2.3 million coins and flips right here. And we're going to try to make some coins, right? We're going to try to see this market rise. Hopefully it does. People buy some teams. And hopefully we get some information about Winter Refresh today, hopefully a loading screen, stuff like that, because a lot of us are wanting icon swaps, a lot of us are just wanting something else, right? Because this Future Stars is coming to a close, and we're just kind of curious to see what's next. EA kind of have us on this spin cycle of promos. They've got us used to expecting stuff every single week, so we will have to see what they drop this week on Friday. Winter Refresh seems to be that promo, but we will see. Hopefully we get some information from EA Sports today. If you like this video, smash a thumbs up on it. Comment down below if you have questions. And of course, subscribe if you're new. It's been Nate, the Foot Accountant, and I will catch you guys later. Peace out.